Thank you. Yeah, you should totally get on TS with me when you get a chance. Makes it a lot easier to talk. The only drivers that I had to really install were my video card drivers, and that was it. On Windows 10. No problem. Oh yeah. Have you tried out the Crusader addition to this? I don't even, you have the game yet or no? Okay, yeah, you have the game then. Oh. Yeah, so they back in December they added Crusader, which is kind of like a the test for the persistent universe, and then they just updated to Crusader 2.4, which actually adds persistence into the game. But they it's still beta test persistence, so like every time they patch, they reset the persistence and all that stuff. It's pretty exciting to see it. I haven't had a much. Yeah, well, if I can get the game to load. I'm trying to get everything set with the live stream, and I'm just trying to go back and forth between windows, and it's a beta test version of a game, so it's not really that. It doesn't like being minimized. Yeah, the community is pretty interesting for Star Citizen. You see a lot of, I guess you could say, ultra fanboys that are hardcore about the game. You've got the regulars, like I'd consider myself a regular. I'm not like aboard the hype train like some players are. And then you have like reverse fanboys that, the game's never coming out. It's a scam. Your money's gone. And it's an interesting community. It's been evolving. I've been kind of paying attention to it. You had these like this white knight, I like circle jerk almost. That they felt like up until the Crusader came out, they were just riding this train of like, oh, if we're good, we're gonna win no matter what. The pirates will never win. The bad guys will never win. Uh-oh, what just happened here? Huh. That's unfortunate. My hornet decided to take off without me. I kind of want to see what's gonna go on here. Whoa! Something just. Oh, wow. So, I'm not sure if another player had the same problem I had, and just by chance our two Hornets collided, or another player took off and crashed into my Hornet, but there are now two dead Hornets and the debris of such floating around Port Olisar. I need to look at the key bindings because they changed everything on me, and I've been pressing keys and other things have been happening, and it's been an interesting debacle, I guess. Where do I turn on my flashlight? Yeah, they released a printable key map, but you can't really print it because the letters are too small. Okay, I'll just walk around in the dark until I find something. Okay, good. Somebody's coming out this airlock. Kind of confused what was happening. Didn't they go in and decided they wanted to come back out? Oh, hi. Get out. They certainly make it a pain in the ass to get into a ship. But I do like the level of immersion where you have to go out the airlock. Yes. Yes, they have. So that's interesting. I can pay money and get my Hornet sooner, or I can just use my Gladius. Yes. Because my ship is insured, so I guess insurance is giving me a new one. Yep. Yeah. I don't have a lot. I forget where it went. Damn it. I only have like 6 month insurance, I guess, upon game release for all my ships. However, I currently have the Hornet because I actually upgraded my Hornet to the Buccaneer, but that is not playable yet, so I kind of have to sit tight and wait.
Do not engage, pilot. Leave this to the professionals.
Oh yeah. Apparently, right now you can walk outside of the airlock without a suit on, and you die. Yes. And when that changed, they added the warning signs like, you know, you must wear a suit beyond this point. Which I thought was a nice touch, and actually there were people in the community that took that sign, a screenshot of it, and printed it out and put it in like their place of work.
Aegis Combat Assist activated. Systems green. Landing complete. Landing gear.
This is Crusader security. We need civilians to clear the area.
I used to. Yeah, I'm kind of getting back into it. I took about... over the next 48 hours, my task in life is to prepare 20 pounds of smoked pork shoulder. So... Well, I just started soaking them, so I'm preparing myself for tomorrow. So I'm going to stay up and, like, not sleep. And then I will go to sleep probably pretty early this morning, and then wake up around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, start the smoker, and for the next 24 hours after that, I will be manning the smoker.
Contact. Contact. Begin scan. Contact. Contact.
Where did my... That's what I'm looking for.
Quantum travel initiated.
I used to have a dedicated Twitch setup where I had a computer that actually streamed to Twitch for me. So my gaming computer did not get Yeah, so my gaming computer wouldn't get bogged down.
Head shield under fire. Rear shield under fire. Foot shield under fire. Shields recharging. Shields recharging.
I'm really surprised I haven't torn off a part of my ship in this engagement yet. There we go, I'm dead. I think he's probably dead too. That was a pretty hard hit. I want to walk out of the airlock with no suit on. Yep. I pull. I'm gonna do it, man. I'm gonna do it. Here we go. Oh no! Wasn't as violent as I expected. I expected to see like blood show up, you know, as my body decompresses. Right now, I'm in a huge respawning, but the story for the main game is supposed to be you basically, if you die, you create a new character, and that character is a new member in the family of characters that you are playing as, and the assets get willed down to you, you know, your new character, but not necessarily a reputation. Yes, and I want to see how that plays out, because I have a feeling a lot of people are going to play the game very aggressively, and then they realize that there's actually a real negative to death in this game, and then they're going to play a lot more conservatively. I hope. Oh, absolutely. No, Morin, come back! This is going to be very interesting. I really don't think this is going to work against like a 22-ton space fighter, but I'm hoping I can bump it to stop it rotating. Yeah, there's an animation involved with that, so I don't know if it'll work. Yeah, you know what's going to happen though is the ship's going to disappear somehow, and then I'm going to be out here like a click away from the space station floating in space. Nope. Okay, I open the canopy up. Thank you, Magical Animations.
Warning, systems overheating. Bogey, scanning.
I'm probably the only Hornet in this game right now. Yes, it does.
Bogey, scanning. Bogey.
I haven't really had enough experience with the shooter aspect. I do like what I've seen, but I'm really eager to see the larger ships and how first-person shooter plays out on that, like boarding ships and things like that. I had an experience that has left me craving more when this Crusader first came out. Basically, a buddy of mine and I floated away from the station on EVA to the point where ships would kind of start, you know, like taxiing to land. And we waited for a larger one, the Retaliator Bomber, to come in. And he kind of hovered over landing space, waiting for a ship to clear out. We actually stowed on board and actually killed the crew and stole the ship.
Bogey, scanning.
Yeah, I thought that was really cool.
The wrong bonus spice to fly through.
It's kind of yours until it blows up.
Aft, shields charged.
I'm sorry.
Shields charging.
Shoot. Another crash. Come on, that ship was intact. I could have survived that. Maybe not fly it home. What were you saying before? Yes. The mechanic right now is if I spawn a ship on the pad, it's locked until I go and get in one of the seats on board. And then it's kind of free reign. I'm not sure what they're going to do as far as like maybe a permission system on board. Like you need some sort of authentication from the owner to be able to use certain things. I'm gonna try something that's not going to one of these station things. The comm arrays.
Selection confirmed. Your ship is currently being delivered to the launch platform.
Oh, I'm not wearing a suit. I would have too. Now the arduous process of finding which room is mine. All right, those red panels make it easy to figure out. There we go. I think this is mine. Cornays. Oh, nope, I'm dying. I thought I put my suit on. Well, oops. Let's try this again. Certainly does. So I actually cannot wait till the larger ships come out, like the Idris, the frigates, and the larger stuff, because I want to board one, take the crew captive, especially, you know, once the death mechanics come into play where there's a serious consequence to dying, and then taking two of them, throwing a pistol into the airlock and telling them have a, you know, like a, I don't know, a Thunderdome. Whoever lives, lives. Whoever dies gets jettisoned out of the airlock. And if you both refuse, then I'll open the external airlock.
Your ship is currently being delivered to
yes,
the
I want that. Yeah. Yes. So glad I have two ships. It makes stupid mistakes like the one I just made a little easier to swallow.
Aegis Combat Assist activated. Systems green. Landing gear retracted.
Yeah, I haven't even really looked at shrouds.
Contact. Begin scan.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Contact. Begin scan. Quantum travel initiated.
Yeah, I think creating an account for it? I don't know. It's been a while. I
guess. Complete.
Random ship. Come in, random ship. Hi. Welcome to the neighborhood. Second class junior cartographer Tessa Bannister reporting in. I'm the eyes behind all the ICC scan probes in the area. What these little guys see, I see. Which, yes, means I can totally see you. Right now.
Yeah, I mean, we've got all the old school experience, all the upcoming games pretty much under our belts, and these new kids will, I don't know, they'll be blind to it.
If you have a second, could you check out these coordinates? Scans are saying something's there, but can't ID it.
Yes.
Flare ready. Quantum travel initiated.
Yeah, the VR stuff's interesting. I can't wait to see it get applied. You're saying that Star Citizen's supposed to be primary VR for display, but we'll see what happens with that. I haven't really seen much in the way of that. I know you can use VR right now in it, but it's not really. You know, like 3D movies, like some 3D movies are just really crappy, like use of 3D, let's just like throw stuff in your face. But I remember watching Tron in 3D and I was just like, holy crap, this is how you're supposed to do 3D. You know, like it seems real gimmicky from what I've seen so far. Besides, of course, Contact. The head tracking.
Contact. Begin scan.
Oh boy. Got a
Contact.
Target here.
Begin scan. Contact. Begin scan.
See, now the issue here is I'm in a PvP zone, so this guy may very well shoot me. And he's in an area where there's no comm array coverage, so if he kills me, there's no like bounty that goes on his head.
Begin scan. Contact.
And there's another player here. So that guy's a freelancer. He's probably not going to engage me. I'm worried about the... Okay, he jumped out. So I was worried about the Hornet that jumped out, and the Freelancer just jumped out, so I'm clear for now. Unless there's a ghost or somebody hiding here, and then I'm absolutely screwed.
Contact. Begin scan. Contact.
Get out of here. Will you still
begin
care?
Scan.
That's what a lot are gonna do. What the hell is that? Well, I've got something for you.
Missile lock.
That worked.
Missile lock.
So I used to have these cluster missiles attached to this were like absolutely hell. It would basically fire at a target, get nearby, and then launch like 8 little tiny, impossible to lose homing like tracking missiles that were super agile. So you would break a lock on it, it would go into panic mode, fire off 8 more, which would require the lock, and then you'd pretty much done. I think they've nerfed them.
Contact. Begin scan.
So before this latest patch, I have actually, I used to go here and sit here and park on one of the asteroids nearby and shut down all systems. I'd go completely dark. So my radar and heat signature would be below the ambient, so I would basically be invisible on radar. And I would sit here and wait for somebody to get close, and then I would just turn on all my shit and just chase after them. Yeah, I love that mechanic. It's pretty interesting because, like, you can fly different places where you're, you know, like the ambient background, like heat and that sort of thing, are higher, so it's easier to disappear. Or there's situations where it's higher or lower. It's pretty cool. Yes. I need to know how to get out of my ship without ejecting it. Exit seat. M1. Modifier 1, which is Alt. So Alt F. That didn't work. Damn you, keybinding, you lie to me again. Like the Friday's handle. Well, there's eject. I don't want to do that, though. Yeah, I mean, that'll work, but I won't be able to get back into the ship. Ah, that was the trick. I had to hold the key combination.
Contact. Danger. System overheating.
Yeah. Oh no. I don't know. I know they're looking for things like that for various like exploration aspects, but I don't know what depth they're gonna do that.
Jenny, think you could head on back and whip us up a cup of something hot? I'm about to pass out. Got a contact. Multiples. Let's see what the ridges say. Not coming up. Forget the drink! I need you on shield now!
Probably.
Danger. System overheating. Shields recharging. Begin scan.
Did I finish that? I don't know. So they've got this mode called cruise mode, which is you fly really fast, and it causes actually problems for dogfights, because a lot of guys will mid-dogfight realize they're getting their shit pushed in and go to cruise mode, and then there's really nothing you can do. So I hope that they do something kind of like what we saw in Freelancer, so they had like essentially missiles that were really fast that could
shields
hit something and knock it out of like cruise mode and like disable it for a certain amount of time, which I imagine they'll probably do, because obviously Freelancer and Star Citizen have the same, you know, director or whatever you want to call them.
Quantum travel initiated.
Yeah. Well, so it's essentially the idea behind cruise mode is for traveling short distances where quantum travel is just too much.
Quantum travel complete.
Because quantum travel is like 20% light speed, so that might be unwieldy in certain situations.
From these coordinates. You should help if you can.
A distress beacon, great.
Quantum travel initiated.
Alrighty. Appreciate you coming and hanging out with me for a little while. All right, later.
Quantum travel complete. Shields recharging. Head Plate shield under fire. Shields recharging. Flare drop. Chaff drop. Flare ready. Chaff ready. Contact. Contact. Begin scan. Engines low. Engines low. Shields up. Engines low. Quantum travel initiated. Engines low. Engines low.
Quantum travel complete.
Engines low. Contact. Begin scan. Quantum travel initiated. Landing mode engaged. Weapons mode engaged. Landing mode engaged. Automated landing initiated. Manual landing initiated. Weapons mode engaged. Landing mode engaged. Landing request approved. Automated landing initiated. AP activated. Landing gear deployed. Landing complete.
Let's fix you up. Good to go. Thanks for choosing CryAstro. Fly safe. Looks like your ship's all full up. You're clear to take off. Fly safe.
Landing gear retracted. Quantum travel initiated. Quantum travel complete. Quantum travel initiated. Quantum travel complete. Quantum travel initiated. Quantum travel complete. Contact. Begin scan. Landing mode engaged. Contact. Begin scan. Contact. Begin scan. Landing request. Approved. Contact. Begin scan. AP activated. Landing gear deployed. Contact. Begin scan.
Engage, pilot. Leave this to the professionals.
Landing complete.
that thing over there. Let's kill it.
Not enough spirit.
What you ask is impossible.
Not dead. You have my thanks, but a word of warning. These animals carry a plague and must be killed before it spreads. You created a potion to fight it. I cut one of them open and took its innards. They smell it on me. That's why they're attacking.
I don't have enough spirit.
Here, take this as my way of saying thanks.
And wealth, and he spent every moment of his life trying to protect it. I was his flesh and blood, but he cared more about the names in books and the faces of the paintings on the walls than his living daughter. what fear is. The fear of who you are. The fear of what your own blood would do if they knew what you were. No, you could never understand it. People see you as a savior. Have you ever thought about the lives you've taken? They were fathers, lovers, daughters.
Thank you.
foul stench.
Can't we go to the palace instead?
Take what you can, never apologize.
Has raised me to new heights. My understanding grows. My mind is stronger. My strides grow longer.
Do I know of the one rocker? There you go. He roams the outskirts of Pandemonium, a lumbering giant with a gaping hollow at its core. Somehow, it can hide its body away, disguising itself as a mere portal. Those who pass through it are trapped in a distant world. Never to be seen again.
That creature will die. My understanding grows. Thank you. longer. My strides grow longer. My understanding grows.
Crystal has acted as a prison for centuries, but Malfeo's actions weaken, threatening to release the demons within. What can we do?
Be ready.
My strides grow longer.
There must be others who seek a way out of the endless strife. Angels and demons who feel enslaved by our fate. I cannot be unique in all of creation. I know my path. I will find those disillusioned of the war and lead them.
Those victories might last a day, or a year, or 100 years. The war will never be won so long as he and his brothers lead. There is no end. Fools like my father are too blind to see it.
I need healing. My path becomes clearer.
I was struck down in a third charge. I lay upon the ground, only to wake in chains. I did not know that demons took prisoners. I babbled like a fool about my dreams of escaping this war. My captor freed me and said that we would meet again. Her name was Lilith, daughter of Mephisto.
Prisoner in the battle, an angel whose light was dimming. I brought him to my lair for my amusement, but he surprised me. My touch seemed to breathe life into him, He raved like a madman about how he wished to escape the war. Perhaps I have found someone I can use.
What you ask is impossible. Comes clearer.
Thank you.
My strides grow longer. Clearer. Stronger.
For a party. My path becomes clearer.
Thank you.
raised me to new heights. This fight is over.
Turning to town. Well done. Here is your reward. You have finished all the bounties here, but more await you in other lands.
What you ask is impossible. I will not do that. Increased.
Thank you.
understanding grows. My strides grow longer. My path becomes clearer. My understanding grows. I need to go back.
That's my choice, too. That's just the thing.
I will not do that.
very pretty view here. The scenery is interesting in these parts. The ground is... Are we going to do anything?
Should fight evil alone. Let me aid you.
I must wait till
help
you
me.
Have the ability.
It's inside me. Inside.
Ability is not yet recharged. Ready yet.
Ready yet.
must wait to use that ability. It is not ready yet. I must wait to use that ability. That ability is not yet recharged. Wait to use that ability. Ability is not yet recharged.
Not enough speed. Wait to use that ability.